somebody who I know probably touched almost everybody in this entire episode. And touched me personally as well, you know. Justin Bennington, make some noise for Justin. I learned a lot watching him live his life. He taught me so much, and when I close my eyes and think about him, I think about his face, which was always smiling. I think about his heart, which he wore on his sleeve. I think about how kind he treated both me, my brother, Tomo, the band. I think about what he taught me about pursuing your dreams, pursuing your passion relentlessly, but at the same time being able to have an incredible family. You know, he had six incredible children as well. And every time we spoke, it wasn't a conversation that we had that didn't include something about his family. And what you guys, I think, get a sense of from Linkin Park, and it certainly was an extension of how Chester lived his life, is Linkin Park, it's not just the band, it's a family. And the way they think about you guys, very similar to 30 Seconds to Mars, it's a giant family, and we try to make something more than just get on stage and play music. We try to connect and communicate in a way that's deep and meaningful, and I learned that from Chester. He did it night after night after night after night. Well, what about that voice? What about that voice? That voice will live forever. And I'm gonna sing a song a lot of people here probably don't know. It's called Alibi. Got back up and in the air. there's anyone here who ever feels like there's no hope and you are at the end of the road, you gotta reach out. You gotta say what you're thinking about. You gotta share it with your friends, with your family. Don't give up. Do not give up. I found in my life the absolute greatest breakthroughs of my entire life have been just beyond the darkest moments. I've always found that. So anyway, I just wanted to give you that.